I am Ilse Anysas-Salkauskas, a Western Canadian mixed media artist. I'm known for using unconventional materials and techniques to comment on issues of landscape, land use, and environmental preservation. I live near a small Western Alberta town called Cochrane, which is located about 20 kilometers west of Calgary. In Cochrane, I met a seamstress who was creating Western clothing using colorful leather. In her studio, she had several boxes filled with leather scraps that she wasn't using anymore, so I was able to use them to create my upcycled leather fringe tapestries for quite a few years until she retired. The first large recycled leather fringe tapestry I created is in the collection of the Cambridge Art Gallery. It is about 190 centimeters by about 117 centimeters in size. It's called Mountain Memories. The inspiration for that work came from several riding trips that my husband and I made going into the mountains. That one day, it was early morning, it had been a hot summer, and the Rocky Mountains were disappearing in a misty, hazy, almost smoky atmosphere. And that atmosphere lasted for almost a couple of minutes and burned itself in my memory. And when I came home, I recreated that. This piece that I'm standing in front of is called Rising from the Ashes. It is free-floating. I attached the strings to the very top of the board, and then made knots, square knots, all the way down. I also added a different element to this one. And this one has smaller, shorter pieces of knots attached to a longer fringe. So I have this three-dimensional effect at the top and the flat two-dimensional effect at the bottom. And it's when you move along this piece, it changes the colors because some of the colors from the back come to the foreground. The inspiration for this piece came from a trip that a girlfriend and I made traveling through the Rocky Mountains several years ago, and we encountered a fire. We knew there was a fire in the area, but we had not expected to turn a corner and all of a sudden have a flame right in front of us hit some of the trees. And a couple of years later, my husband and I drove down that same road and found that the entire area was rejuvenating. So I decided to create a tapestry, calling it Rising from the Ashes. I'm standing next to the sculpture that I call Stories My Mother Told Me. My mother, many years ago, moved to Cochrane once she retired. And living in Cochrane, I had a chance to visit my mother and talk about Lithuania, where she was born, and find out a lot of the stories that I didn't have a chance to talk to her about when I was younger and living away from home. Now I had a chance to find out that she had grown up on a farm. And then, of course, she moved to the city, eventually having to leave Lithuania and emigrating to North America. Eventually, we found out that my grandfather's property had been collectivized by the communists, and a great big field was made out of his property and all the properties around his property. So when I created the sculpture, I'm showing plain fields, nothing on them, just a variety of fields that are just unevenly placed because the fields probably right now look just as uneven as can be. And in the back, I have added green to show that my grandfather originally had orchards and small forests on his property. So my grandmother wore a black wedding dress when she got married. And these black pieces here represent my grandmother's black wedding dress. I've added this piece here on both sides of the sculpture, which shows that my mother was religious, and so was her grandmother and her mother. This sculpture I connect to my mother, my grandmother, and the grandmother before the grandmothers. A group of women that have all worked hard to survive on the property that my grandfather eventually inherited. I had troubles carrying my larger tapestries around when they ended up in exhibitions, so I decided it was time I created smaller ones. And I created about 20 of them. One of the ones that I want to show you is called Springtime Surprise. In Alberta, we have surprise snowstorms, and this was one of them. My flowers were really shocked and surprised to see the snow hitting them. So in this one, you see the white leather represents the snow, and the colorful leather represents the flowers. I hope you enjoyed seeing a small part of my art practice. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.